has been good.
Amen.
He has afforded us life.
Yes. Amen. Amen.
He has afforded us this opportunity to lift up his name.
Praise his name.
And I was wondering when I was being introduced by Pastor Green, he has known so much about me. But I give God thanks for this privilege. Let me greet you, Pastor Green, and Evangelist Green, and all the evangelists and the missionaries and the deacons and the saints of God on this set. Let me greet you in the most precious name, the name of Jesus.
Praise his name.
Before I go into the words, I just want to sing this song, this little chorus. Because I listened to the testimony and I realized that shutting has caused a loss of hope. Shutting has caused some discouragement. The situation that surrounds has caused depression. But there is hope in God.
Amen.
Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Mighty warrior, you are great in battle. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Mighty warrior, you are great in battle. Jehovah is your name. One more time. Jehovah is your name. Jehovah is your name. Mighty warrior, great in battle, Jehovah is your name.
Praise the Lord.
Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of the Lord.
Thank you, Jesus.
Praise, hallelujah.
Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
For our night's reading, Exodus 15, 29 through to 31. And it reads thus, but the children of Israel walk upon dry land in the midst of the sea, and the waters were a wall unto them on their right hand and on their left. Thus the Lord saved Israel that day out of the hand of the Egyptian. And Israel saw the Egyptian dead upon the seashore. And Israel saw that great work which the Lord did upon the Egyptian. And the people feared the Lord and believed the Lord and his servant Moses. Bless the name of Jesus. Tonight, my topic is Give Me Back My Praise. Those of you who know the colloquial language that we use here, Give Me Back My Praise.
Amen.
We would have said in the English language, Give Me Back My Praise. But we are going to use it in the local language, Give Me Back My Praise.
Amen.
And so tonight, when we look on the situation that Moses and the children of Israel when what they were going through, we are no different from them. But Moses, as a leader, he stood with the commander. He listened to the commander. And so from the very beginning, from Genesis 3, when we go back, we notice that the devil wanted to steal the joy from the church. He wanted to take away what we are supposed to have. And in Genesis 3, whereby the devil deceived the woman, beguiled her, took away the part whereby God wanted them to have a close relationship in worship, in praise, in honor, in glory. He took that away. And so he go down through the ages. After he left them and God had to kill a lamb and place the two angels with the flaming sword at the garden gate to keep them out. But then God had a way mapped out for mankind.
Amen.
He did not leave them alone. Amen. He did not say, I am finished with you. He had hope for them. Yeah. And in this COVID time, God have hope for us.
Amen.
But we only have to look to him. We only have to look to him. Right at one stage, we had freedom like Adam and Eve.
Yes.
We could go to church and we could shout and we could worship. But now that freedom, because of the COVID dilemma, we have to stay in our house. But that doesn't stop us from shouting. That doesn't stop us from praising God. That doesn't stop him from giving the glory that is due to his holy name. And so, when the devil tried to stop the praise, tried to stop the glory with mankind, God said, it's not finished. It's not over. And so it came down the ages. Cain killed his brother. That was another hindrance.
My God.
That was another barrier. Worship could not go on. Worship and praise was hindered by the devil. And as we look down through the ages, coming down from Cain and Abel, we have Noah. Oh, hallelujah. That man was a man that was perfect in God's sight. But the people he preached for 120 years. But mankind did not accept God. Mankind did not want to worship God. Mankind did not want to praise God. They wanted to do what they want to do. And so God, in Noah's days, he said, Noah, you build me that ark. And a time came, they jeered him. Oh, you're building this ark and there is no flood. But when the rain started and God told them, listen, put in the animals 2 by 2. And the unclean ones you're going to put in. And so God, mankind was shut out because they did not want to worship God.
Bless the Lord.
When you worship God, when you give God a glory, you're in connection with him. The devil cannot come around. The devil cannot stop your praise. The devil cannot stop your joy. The devil cannot stop your blessing when you give God the honor, when you give him the praise, when you give him the glory. Yes. And so it moves from Noah and it comes down to Abraham. Oh, hallelujah. Abraham, he struggled. Abraham, he struggled, but he held on. And so we are struggling. The church is passing through. The church has gone through many murky and dark waters, but God's hands have lifted us out.
Amen.
Praise God.
Praise
Bless the
Lord.
Name of Jesus.
Bless the Lord.
And so when we look down through the ages, how the devil wants to stop our praise, how the devil initiates so many things to block the mind, to put the mind aside. But the Bible says we have to renew our mind.
Amen, amen.
We have to get connected with him. We have to see him high and lifted up. When we come down to Moses, hallelujah. When we come down to Moses, Pharaoh's hand was so hard on the children of God, but they pressed their way through because God had a commander. God had a leader for the children of God. And when God spoke to Moses, when God said, Moses, you will have to go down to deliver my people. My people that are in bondage. My people are enslaved by Pharaoh. But you are my deliverer for them. And so Moses, he went down. And Moses had the unction from God. God did not send him down there unprepared. God prepared him and said, you're going where you're going to see astrologers. You're going to see soothsayers. You're going to see Obeah man. You're going to see Reader man. You're going to see all those men. But they are not the God that will deliver. Amen. I am the God. I am that will deliver you. Amen. And so he kept his eye on him. And so when Pharaoh did all that he could, he held them. He held the people. He holds them down. But God, in his love and his mercy for Israelites, he said, we're going to kill the firstborn. When he said all the plagues, when he said all of them upon Pharaoh, Pharaoh's heart was hardened, and he kept the children of God. But then when God killed the firstborn of everything, that was what shook him up. He told Moses, take your people and get out. My oh, hallelujah.
My God.
He held on to their praise. He held on to their glory. He held on to what they had. But God said, no, it's a time. My people need deliverance. My people need to show me that I am God and I will give them the glory. And so he drove them out. But in driving them out, he still wanted to pursue them. And so when they came to the Red Sea, when they came at a spot where there was conflict, some of them were saying, I want to go back to Egypt. I want to eat cocoa and garlic. You, Moses, brought me out here to die. But Moses wasn't listening to them. He was listening to the commander. He was hearing from God. God was speaking to him because he was a deliverer. And he wanted God's people to have back their praise.
Amen.
Bless the
Amen.
Name of Jesus. Bless the name of the Lord.
Bless the Lord.
And so yes. When the conflict started, when the conflict at the Red Sea, God said to Moses, don't worry, my boy. I'm going to give you the instruction. The pillar of cloud by day that was following them, the pillar of cloud, the fiery one. And so God put the fiery one so that the adversary could not see the Egyptian. And the cloud was there. And so he rolled back. He said, Moses, put your hands across so that the waters can be divided. And he stretched his hand, and water rolled up as wall. Water rolled up as wall. My God is a deliverer. My God is a miracle worker. And so he rolled the water up. Can you imagine?
Amen.
And that night the Bible said, the wind blew. The wind blew. The wind blew and dried the ground so that the people of God can walk through. And so,
God,
when they saw that, when they saw what God did, he said, they walked through on dry land. The enemy decided to follow them, but God said, stand still, my children. Just look up. From whence cometh your help? Your help cometh from me. Don't worry yourself, don't cry, just look unto me. And so they pursued. The walls were there with water. Mountains were on either side. But Pharaoh holds them. They were coming. They were coming, God, because they thought they could get the Israelite. But once you're an Israelite, you're covered under the blood. Once you're a child of God, God have his hands around you. God sustain you with his word. So you're covered from the adversary. And as the Egyptian come in, they were coming in, and when they reached the middle of the water, oh Jesus, can you imagine? You were fearful. Some were fearful, some were in doubt, but when they saw what God did, when they saw what God was doing, the Bible said they fear God and they magnify God, they glorify God. And when they reached in the middle, because of the glory and the praise, because they honor to his name, hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. The miracle working God just made a way and rolled back the water. And the Bible said the Egyptian, oh God, that the Israelites saw, oh,
no more.
God, they'll see them no more because that water.
Thank you, Jesus.
Tonight.
Thank you, Jesus.
We serve a God to be praised.
Yes.
Amen. Serve a God that we have to say, devil, you took my joy. You took my praise. Devil, you took everything away from me. You become sadder because of this COVID. You become depressed. You feel like you're all alone. But although you feel that way, God said, I'll never leave you. I'll never forsake you. I'll bring you out as pure gold. Just fight and ride through your storm. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. Hallelujah. Yes. You have to trust God. Yes. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart. Lean not on your own understanding. Yes. In all thy ways, acknowledge him, and he shall direct. Hallelujah. My mighty Redeemer, glory to God. All who is discouraged tonight, all who feel depressed and sad, all who feel like nothing is going on for them, look to God. Look to God. David said when he run through the troop, when he leap over the wall, he said, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall come
continually in my mouth.
I will boast of the Lord. Glory to God. If you are not boasting of God, you cannot ride over. If you are not lifting up the name of Jesus, you will always be in depression. But tonight, glory to God. Oh, glory to God. Oh, glory to worship God. When there is nothing, worship God. Because he promised that he will feed you. He said, clothe the lily. He feed the birds. Much more we, our children. Put your trust in God. Walk with God. Talk with God. Worship God. And take him back that what the devil has stolen
from you.
Bless the name of God. Bless the name of the Lord. Bless the name of Jesus. Bless the name of Jesus. We want to worship God as children of God. We want to worship God. If you don't have anything today, tomorrow God will provide.
Amen. Amen.
God give you back your praise. And so, as we go further, God, when Moses and the children of Israel cross over, the Bible said Miriam played her timbrel. Oh God, I can imagine how she feel, how those fingers felt when she played her timbrel. I can imagine all the people shout, the doubting ones, they realize that God is real. Time we are in the church.
Thank you, Jesus.
We call ourselves children of God. But when we are going through a little thing, we give up and we say, Lord, I'm tired. I can't make it. Oh, God is pushing you and say, yes, I'm giving you the strength. You just sit and say, I can't make it. But the devil will take hold of you. If you can't make it, God, the devil is going to take you over. And we do not want no one to be lost.
Amen.
And we don't want anybody not to have the praise. Because in this COVID time, if you don't have a praise, you're going to be in sinking sand.
Go down.
God. But you have to have your praise. There might not be food in the cupboard. The coffers might be empty. But give God a glory. Job, the Bible said Job lost everything. Job lost family, cattle, everything. But in all of that, Job, the Bible said, Job shaved his head and he worshiped God. How many of us?
God.
How many of us? But we want to take the example out of the book of God, whereby he said, worship. Give him honor and glory, because there is no God like him. There is none like him.
Jesus.
None before and none to come. So we have to give God the praise. Give about the praise. God Almighty. Some of us, we are at home. The children are our problem. Oh, great God. But put them before God. Trample around them when they are asleep. You go in the room and you lift up your hand, because God can break the fetters.
Amen, amen, amen.
Praise God.
Many times I go into my son's room, he's fast asleep, but I say, God, here is he. You can do it. You can turn him around. You can train. I'm just waiting on you, Lord.
Yes.
And I want to have the praise. And I want my entire family to have the praise. Because when a family stays together and give God the glory, it breaks down Satan's kingdom.
Amen.
Satan's darkness will flee you.
Praise God.
God. Oh, glory to God.
Praise the Lord.
Bless the name of
praise
Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Bless the name of
praise
Jesus.
God.
Bless your name.
God.
And stay tonight. When I listen to the testimony, I know some people are not working. And finances is one of the big issues today, because we have bills and we have our thing to get around with. I listened to the lady with the testimony. For 1 year, she did not drive. But when God ready, sister dear, you drive. When God ready, he provides for you. You just have to praise him. You just have to give him the honor. You said you were in a backslidden condition. You were in the time that you were going to give up. And that's the time. Maybe you pray a special prayer and God just throw up for you. You just take back your prayers. Give me back the prayers. Somebody Amen. Took that from you. The devil took back. Take that. But you come to him and you say, Satan, give me back the prayers. It's like somebody has something for you and you want it. You're not gonna give me back the something, man. No want it, no. We have got it with the authority, with the Holy Spirit that God has invested in us tonight. Give me back my praise. I'm too much at my red sea. I'm too much in my barren condition. I'm too much in a lost way. But I come to get back my praise. Glory to God.
Glory.
Oh, hallelujah. 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 Esther. Esther. They wanted to take back her praise, but she knew God. She knew God. Everybody was saying, no, it's not the time to go to king. But Esther said, whether it's time or not, I'm going to see the king. I'm going to see the king for my people. And so tonight, we as children of God, we have to go and see the king for our people, that they are not destroyed. Bless the name of Jesus. And so when Esther, when all the chamberlain, all those that work for her, they were, we would call them our little maid, our closest maid, our little servant. When she said to them, oh God, I'm going to see the king. They were in conflict. They said, no, I don't want you to see king. Now is not the time to see king. King is going to kill you. Esther had a connection with God. Mordecai on the outside had a connection with God. The people of God had a connection. And so Esther said, if I perish, I perish, but I'm going to see the king. Tonight we want to see the king. Tonight we want to see the king in whatever situation we are in. Mark your
Amen.
Some of us, we are just thinking of the material things.
But this material thing will soon pass away. And we have to stand up before the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We have to give an account. But if you don't have that praise, how can you stand up? The praise is your joy and the joy of the Lord. Hallelujah. The joy of the Lord is your strength.
Amen.
Glory to God. I want to keep the joy in this time.
Oh God.
Enemy going to come upon you. Enemy is going to soar you. Enemy is going to say all manner of evil against you. But as they say, Christian put his hand in his ear and he trod the road because he wanted to keep his praise.
Amen.
Amen. I want to keep my praise. I want to take it back and I want to keep it. Many a years, the devil fight, but I put up fight. In my last years in the government work, I was a postmaster. And when the devil creeped in one morning, they didn't know that I was a handmouth because I didn't go anywhere more than I went to work and stay in that office. And I said, one morning the adversary came in and the Spirit of God lift me. I took back my joy. I took back my praise. I took back my laughter. I showed them that the God that I serve is not the Baal God. He's not a Dagon God, but he's God who lives and reigns and progress in mankind. And so when God lift me, I went upstairs and I went downstairs and I came outside. That one lady came to me and said to me, Mrs. Amy, I didn't know you were so powerful. I said, not me powerful, God in me, because greater is he that is in you than he that is in the world. And we have to show the world what we have. We have a great God. We have a God that never fails. We have a God that can break up. We have a God that can pull up. When you are in conflict, God just make the way and give you the praise and the worship and the glory. Tonight, I'm talking to myself. The devil wants to rob us of our praise. The devil wants to rob us of our shout. But it doesn't matter where you are. If you are in Walmart, and I know Walmart is big, I've been there. And if you are in Walmart and you feel like shouting, let them look on you and say, this is a mad man. This is a mad woman. But you are claiming the name of Jesus. Many times they look at me and they say, I'm a mad woman. When God anoint me, when God give me the word, when God said, shout the praises, I can't keep this big mouth shut. I have to shout and take back my praise from the adversary. Take back your praise tonight.
My God.
Those who are discouraged. I'm talking about the discouraged one. Hope is in God.
Yes.
If you get discouraged now, in this time, you're going to slide away because the devil wants to play with the mind and said, he's not doing anything for you. Nothing is going to work out. If that girl had listened to the voice of the adversary, maybe she wouldn't be driving her four-wheel. Maybe she wouldn't going down the street giving God glory because she had listened to the voice of Satan. But tonight, take back your praise.
Amen.
Take back your worship.
Bless the Lord.
Give God the glory. Don't slacken upon him. Don't slacken upon God because he's not slack concerning his promise. Whatever he promised you, he will deliver. And so, tonight, my encouragement to you all, my encouragement to myself. I know Pastor has a lot in his hand, but Pastor Green, stand firm. Sister Shauna, Evangelist Shauna, you stand by him. Because greater is in you. It doesn't matter what they want to say. It doesn't matter what you want to do. Stand up for righteousness. It will exalt you. The moment you slip from righteousness, you're going to go further and further in sin. But once you stand up for righteousness, they're going to say all manner of evil. They're going to talk to you. They're going to do everything. But stand up for righteousness and worship God and take back
the praise. Take back your worship. Not because you're in your home. When I'm ready, I shout. When I'm ready, I jump and I sing the song of Zion and I jump. Because that is in me. God has given me that. God has given me the power, not of fear, but of a boldness and of a sound mind. When they say I'm mad, I'm not mad. I'm of a sound mind. I know what I'm doing because God is there with me. Even when you come to your Red Sea and it seems like all hope is gone, just worship God.
Amen.
Just give God the glory.
Amen.
Just
amen.
And tonight, my encouragement to all, stand fast in the liberty where Christ has made you free. And be not entangled again. Don't get yourself tied up. Don't get yourself mixed up. But worship God.
Amen.
Worship God.
Beautiful.
Because God is a deliverer.
Thank you,
God is a way maker. God is a problem solver. God is a problem solver. God is a provider. God is a healer. But give him your praise and you see the God you have. If you give him the praise, you will see the God in whom you serve. The three Hebrew boys, the king wanted to take back the praise. They knew of God. They didn't know any statue God. They know the true and living God. And when he called them and said, man, you're going to bow when you hear the music. The brothers said, we do not even care. Because if you are a little nothing, we don't care. But if our God don't deliver, we will not bow. We'll keep our praise.
My God.
We want to keep our eyes on Jesus. Amen. The three Hebrews kept their eyes on Jesus.
Yes.
And even though when they were bound and to be thrown in the furnace, oh God, the king said he saw one. He realized, God let him to realize that I am God. I am with my children. Have no fear, oh God. When we have God, we will have our worship. Amen. When we have given him the glory, he will deliver. And so tonight, lean on the everlasting arms of Jesus. Trust in the Lord. Trust in the Lord. Jehovah is his name. He's a mighty warrior. He's great in battle. No battle has never been lost by him. Battle has been lost by us. But he is our battle axe. He fights the battle for us so that we can claim the victory, so that we can claim our worship. And so tonight, as I leave you, as I come to the end, I just want us to claim our worship. Hold on to your worship. Hold on to your praise. Your barren days will move. Your sad days will move. Your mourning will turn into joy. Your dark seas will have pathway through them. Oh God Almighty, and the enemies that are pursuing, oh God, they will be drowned in that red sea, in that deep sea, in that big sea, because God is your help. God is your light. God, oh, God, he sits high and he look low. And so tonight, rest assured that God is our help. God is our present help in time of trouble. Amen. Let us hold on. Let us be true to him. Even if the husband wants to go, let him go. But you, Sister Shauna, you worship God. And if Sister Shauna wants to leave Pastor Green, you worship God. Because she will have to come back. Because you know who Jesus is. Praise God. David said, I will bless the Lord. I will bless the Lord. He also said, I will lift up mine eyes unto the hills. From whence cometh my help? My help cometh from the Lord who made heaven and earth. For God, he said, he will not suffer my foot to be moved. He that keepeth thee, he neither slumber nor sleep. So tonight, get back your praise. Claim back your praise. Give me back my praise. Anybody want to hinder your praise, just move them out. Roll the stone over them and take back your praise. Take back your glory. Take back your honor. Take back your big up for God, because he's the one. He's the only one. And so tonight, pray for me. My aim, my desire is to take back what the devil has stolen from me and worship God. God bless you. In Jesus' name. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord.
Amen. Amen. Amen.